to present Daniel Alfredsson his Hall of Fame plaque, 2012 inductee Matt Sundin.
Wow. Thank you, Matt. Especially receiving that thing from him. I can't believe we are friends after all the battles we had all the years. But I looked up to him. He was a star before I even started playing in the Swedish League. He was winning world championships and a great role model. It's truly humbling, surreal to be here tonight and receive this great honor, and it's still hard to take in. Thank you to Landon McDonald and Mike Gartner and the entire selection committee. I'm also extremely proud this year to go in alongside Henrik, Daniel, Roberto, Herb, and Rika, who's the first female European player, which is huge. It was a tremendous weekend spending time. Thank you. It's been a tremendous weekend spending time with all of you and your families and get to know even more stories and extremely inspiring. Thank you to Kelly Massey, Craig, and obviously everybody else at the Hall of Fame team for everything you do to preserve the history of our game and make this weekend truly unforgettable. You go above and beyond, and our family and our friends who's all here, we can't thank you enough. It's been unbelievable. I remember playing against Börje Salming, my first year in the Swedish Elite League. He had finished over here, decided to come back and play in Sweden. He's such a legend, and I found myself watching him intently, the king, in warm-ups, and I just couldn't take my eyes off him. The whole warm-up, I could barely shot a puck, I think, just staring at him. So thank you, Börje, for everything you did for all us Swedish players who followed in your footsteps. You're really a true trailblazer. Thank you. And I want to thank Ottawa. From the first day I arrived until now, your support has been amazing. It has meant so much to me and my family. Ottawa has been the perfect place for me to live, work, and raise my family. And it still gives me goosebumps to enter our arena to be reminded of all the many great memories we created there. And I was lucky to play in front of such passionate and knowledgeable fans as well. And I will never forget the Alfie chants. Thank you so much. I'm so proud to represent Ottawa here tonight. So here I am, almost as excited as I was before my first NHL game, many years ago now, being inducted into the Hockey Hall of Fame. I was drafted at the age of 21 in the sixth round, and some might say, had I focused solely on hockey, I might have been drafted earlier. But I believe that playing multiple sports and growing up is what made my career possible. So I want to thank all of my youth coaches who taught me the importance of work ethic, teamwork, while still making it fun. You allowed me to be creative in a safe and positive environment, and I realize now how much you helped me develop, both as an athlete and as a person. The importance of a safe, positive, fun, inclusive environment cannot be overstated. My dream growing up was to play for the Swedish national team. Representing Sweden was always a great honor. World Championships, Olympics, World Cups, and winning the gold medal at the 2006 Olympics remains one of my most treasured moments in my career. Coming over to On Prior for my first day of training camp in 1995, I was super excited, nervous, really nervous, probably a little bit too excited, I guess. Because when I get to the rink first day of practice, I realized I left my skates in Sweden. Not the best of starts. And I was also homesick. I remember calling home every night from the hotel, and I learned pretty quickly that making overseas calls from the hotel phone gets very expensive. I have to thank Marty Straka. He introduced me to calling cards, and that allowed me to keep calling. And he showed me the ropes early on as well. The first few months were a steep learning curve, both on and off the ice, but I was really lucky to have great teammates like Kerry Huffman. He helped me with an important milestone, setting up my first bank account. Randy Conworth, who's a pro's pro. I learned so much from you. Sean Hill, Dennis Vial, and Tom Chorsky, among many others, who helped guide me through that exciting first year. Rick Bonus, my first NHL coach, gave me every chance to succeed. You taught me how to compete in the NHL, and I'll never forget what you told me right after Cam Neely intercepted a cross-ice pass and went in and scored. You pat me on the shoulders like, kid, you're not the first one, and you won't be the last one. Cam does that too. Just don't do it again. And Jacques Martin taught us the power of working together as a team and really brought structure and took us from being one of the bottom teams to one of the better teams in the league that consistently made the playoffs. Thank you. And Brian Murray, best bench coach I ever had. And he gave us the confidence to believe that a team from Ottawa was as good as any team in the league. I remember I was trying to buy a family home and the seller would not move on the asking price. So I went to Brian and hoping he'd tell me how to negotiate a better price. So I asked Brian, do you like the house? And I was like, I think it's perfect for me and the family. And he just looked at me and said, if you like it that much, just pay up. And so I did, and that was typical Brian Murray, always honest and straight to the point. And I miss Brian and our talks about life and hockey. And thank you to all the other coaches and support staff, agents, JP and Klaus is here, without whom this dream would not have been possible. I want to thank Jerry Townsend, Dr. Chow, for helping me extend my career. You've been unbelievable and great at what you do. I also want to thank all my teammates throughout my career. Some are here today, Reds, Philly, Spess, Nealer, Dax, PJ, and Fish. I remember our parents used to come in the dressing room all the time, Garth, Gord, Barry, Reno, just the bonds we were able to create and the times we had. Those were just special and great times. Eric, thank you for helping me extend my career with your energy, enthusiasm, and confidence and presence. You really brought a new energy for me, and also for reintroducing video games back in my life. We had a lot of fun. To my parents, Hase and Ita, thank you for all the sacrifices you made. You allowed me, my brother Henrik, and Cece to grow to become the best we could be. First to Henrik and Cece too. Love you both. Thanks for everything you've done for us. I know it was not always easy for our parents, but I know you did the best way you can, the best you could, and you always found a way to make it work. Dad, you were a very good athlete. You taught me everything from hockey to soccer to ping pong, tennis. And whenever you came home, often exhausted after a day at work as a carpenter, you probably wanted to put your feet up on the couch, but no, you would always play with me outside, all the way till Mom yelled and said, dinner is ready. I'm grateful for all the life lessons you taught me, and above all, the importance of being a good and caring person. and her mom, Ida, without a doubt, the strongest and toughest Alfredsson, and clearly the most stubborn. And I've been told I inherited a little bit of that stubbornness. Mom struggled with health issues for most of her life, and she never let that stop her from being part of everything we did. I remember we were in Copenhagen at the World Championships one year, and Mom had an accident in the morning and had to go to the hospital to get patched up. And when she came back to the hotel, the rest of the group, we already decided we're not going to the game. And she comes in, and the first thing she says, okay, what time are we leaving? And obviously we went to the game and had a great time. But that just showed her she was extremely tough, and not only tough and stubborn, but also very loving. And I miss you so much. The pressures of hockey for some can become unbearable, and mental health issues are a reality of our game. We're long overdue to finally raise the stigma around mental health, and I hope that every player, coach, and manager that spots signs of someone struggling will reach out and help. I was lucky to meet the love of my life, Bibi, when I was 20 years old. Together we raised four beautiful boys, Hugo, Louis, Phoenix, and William. And Bibi, you have always been there for all of us. You are in my wife and mom Hall of Fame, I tell you that. I love you. I love you all, and I'm so very proud of you. I simply would not be here tonight without you guys, that's for sure. So thank you very much, and it's truly humbling to stand here today. Thank you.